It's the Morning Brew with Friends. We have a packed show today. We've got our buddies Chris Dunkus and Tim Sheehan in this morning. We have our friends from Bernalillo County. We're going to be talking about everything Bernalillo County. Our good friend Carlos Contreras is here from Tractor Brewing Company. Alex Perron with Rail Yards. And my buddy Jerry got to park inside today. We're going to be talking about all the hot cars they're going to be showing this weekend. All on the Morning Brew with Friends. I wish the Ferrari had cup holders, because I can't take it's like I'm, my ever-present coffee cup couldn't go. But isn't that thing amazing? I can't wait to hear about Jerry's full, you know, how he ended up with the car and talking about the big. It's called Driving to the Future this weekend, which is the big car show, which I'm really excited about. But first things first, we got our buddy Chris Dunkison in this morning from Comcast, and my old friend Tim Sheehan in this morning. And you guys have a pretty big announcement. I love this.
Absolutely.
Yeah, we're really excited. You know, Comcast has partnered with Boys and Girls Clubs across the country, and in Central New Mexico, we've got a great example of that. Tim and his team have done an amazing job helping the kids in our community, and we're excited that today we're announcing a $100,000 grant to Boys and Girls Club over the next 3 years.
You guys told me it was a big grant. You didn't tell me it was $100,000. That's awesome. What does that do for the clubs? That's got to be huge.
It launches our My.Future, which is a new technology portal for all of our kids.
Cool.
And for our kids, ages 5 to 18, I mean, that's what they're all about. They're not going to be messing around with the old technology we used to use.
Right.
You know, they're using the stuff that's out there now and advancing every day. So this is going to allow our kids to be on those portals and 40 different programs within that portal.
That's cool.
So we're really excited.
That's very cool. Just by computers, I'm assuming internet access through Xfinity.
Absolutely.
That's very cool. Is this at all of the Boys and Girls Clubs all around too?
Yeah, well, for Boys and Girls Club Central New Mexico, we just launched our sixth location this week.
Really?
So we just opened up in Garfield Middle School.
Oh, right
on. So we're in four schools and then our two main sites, but we're really excited. We're launching it at our Heights site, Heights location, and it's off and running.
That's very cool.
Yeah.
So how do you like just like bring it up like casually, like, so Chris, you got like $100,000 lying around? Like how does that conversation even start?
It's kind of been a natural partnership. Yeah. We've worked with Tim and his team on other initiatives, and when this opportunity came up, we've seen what the Boys and Girls Clubs do across the Central New Mexico region. You know, you start with a kid who's age 5, and we've talked before, that if you don't have internet access and the ability to navigate the internet, you know, it's harder to get an education, it's harder to get a job. This helps their families at home. And so this is a natural partnership.
I think most teachers now are putting homework online, extra lessons online, all of that. So if you don't have access to that at home, the Boys and Girls Club is your next spot, right?
Yep. Our Youth of the Year, she says that's how she started coming to the Boys and Girls Club.
Oh, it's for the access.
Absolutely. She did not have her own computer, and she has no internet access. So she comes in and does her homework every day after school at the Boys and Girls Club.
That's very
cool.
And
we couldn't do it without Comcast.
Very cool. Is there a lot of the kids you serve that are facing that digital divide?
Absolutely, yeah. A lot of the kids that we serve, because in the neighborhoods we are, you know, where we're located, Dan, are the ones that need us most.
Right.
You know, so those kids don't have the money for the internet access. They don't have the money for the new laptop and those kind
of
things. And
of course.
So we even try to get them some refurbished laptops in this community. We work with Adelante and some other groups to get these kids computers down the road.
That's great.
Yep.
That's very cool. So, and this is, how long will this grant last?
It's a three-year grant.
3 years.
Yep, three-year grant. We're really excited about it. And it's this My.Future is really phenomenal. Our staff and our kids are excited about it. They've already launched it.
That's awesome.
Yep.
Well, we need to get some photos. Do we have any photos of that?
No,
I don't think we do. We'll get some next time you guys are here. We'll get some photos of the kids playing around, because that sounds like a lot of fun.
So Comcast has been an incredible partner nationally with Boys and Girls Clubs, and for the last several years here, it's been phenomenal with Chris and his team. We have board representative from them, Charles Pettit. They're involved in all of our events. You're going to hear about our new event next week.
Excellent. So, can you get back on the show?
Yep.
Bring some pictures of the kids next week.
Okay.
Then. Yeah,
we will do that.
Because I grew up going to the clubs. Yep. I grew up myself.
You were a club kid? I was.
And I went to the one that was on the old Rio Grande Boulevard. It's not there anymore. It's not a
old
club
town.
Anymore. The old town one. And it was great fun. I made a lot of friends, played basketball there, played pool there. And it was great. It was a great time. And I think that when I was going, it was more of a chance to escape from doing homework.
Gym and swim.
Gym and swim, yeah, if that was it. It was fun that way.
You didn't have a computer there either, did
we
you?
We didn't. Well, it was like 1904. I mean, that was the dark ages. But the computers were, they were space age technology when I was a kid. But the but now is it like, you have the pool table, the snack bar, and the computer lab?
And the computer lab, the tech center, the whole tech center is phenomenal. And it's full speed. We got tablets for the kids. We got laptops for the kids. We got desktops for the kids.
And then you get high speed internet for
the
kids.
Absolutely.
That's very cool.
It's been really cool to see how the mission of Boys and Girls Club has changed. I think, when you were there, it was keep them off the streets and keep them busy.
Well, we just had fun.
Yeah. And now it's that same, but with the addition of let's prepare them for the future and make sure that we have young men and women who are going to do well in our community.
Right. Absolutely.
It's fantastic.
And it's fun with the purpose, but, education is so important, academic success. We want to get every kid to graduate at least from high school.
Yeah.
And to prepare them for that and try to help the schools with that.
Right. Very cool. And then learning all the programs, learning how to actually access the internet, learning how to find everything out is a big thing. Oh, of course.
We recently had a session for kids about Facebook and how it's going to follow you in the future.
Right. You can't really delete that cookie.
Right. It's all that whole thing. Internet safety is big to us. Every kid has to go through an internet safety program before they start.
Very cool.
So
what else is new with Xfinity? I know you guys have been hiring, Chris, at the Comcast spot down here.
We definitely have.
And how's the hiring going?
It's going really well.
Good.
If we're still actively recruiting. Great. So if you're bilingual in Spanish and English, interested in, go to careers.comcast.com. We've definitely got open positions, and we are actively recruiting in Albuquerque.
Very cool. How far along are you guys, too, on the giant remodel over there?
We will be done in early December. We've got the first half of the building is already occupied. We've got a couple hundred people in there.
Are you loving it? Is it great having the new space and having all the new faces?
It's amazing what a few million dollars will do for a building.
No doubt. Or $100,000.
Exactly. It's all relative.
Right. Absolutely. Well, how did you guys meet? How did this come together really originally?
Tim mentioned there's a national partnership with Boys and Girls Club and Comcast. But the exciting thing here is that we've been able to really take that to a new level locally. And that's largely through Tim's efforts. And, he's in the community every day talking about what Boys and Girls Club does.
Absolutely.
And so we were able to look at where can we put our local funding and where can we work with the Comcast Foundation. And this is where we can make the biggest impact in Albuquerque. And it's exciting for me. Frankly, this is the fun part of my job.
No doubt.
I believe, Chris, this is the largest gift from Comcast Foundation given to any nonprofit in New Mexico.
That's correct.
We love it when you guys come on the show and just make some news like this. This is great. Well, congratulations, guys. We'll be back in a couple of seconds on the Morning Brew. We have a packed house. We got the sheriff here. Did you guys meet him? He's bouncing around somewhere.
I think he's looking for you.
He is a great supporter of the Boys and Girls Clubs, too.
Oh, excellent.
Awesome.
Very cool.
And title sponsor to our new event next week.
Oh, really?
Absolutely.
Well, we'll talk all about that in just a couple of seconds on the Morning Brew with Friends.